now take questions from the audience.
My name is Luke Radowski. I'm a Brooklyn College student. Now, with all due respect, and I pardon the discretion, but this is a very important question. On a PBS documentary, Rebuilding America, you made an infamous quote saying, pull it. Now, you later released a press release saying that that was the firefighters outside World Trade Center Building 7 on 9/11. It's two questions. If you meant to pull the firefighters out, why didn't you say evacuate the firefighters? And there's also FEMA reports and first responders that I know personally that firefighters were already out that building before you made that statement. So can you please clarify your statement?
Trade Center was brought down by a combination of events. The first was the falling antenna from the roof of the North Tower. That antenna came crashing down and sliced through the facade in the front of the center. As it did so, it ruptured fuel lines in the building, which fuel lines were there to serve the emergency generators for the city's, emergency response system of the city here was located at 7 World Trade Center. Nevertheless, that antenna sliced through the fuel lines, caught fire. That fire started to burn and burn intensively. That fire seemed to burn through the rest of the day. By, I forget what time it was, must have been around 3:34, about 4:30. Clearly, that building was on its way down. And I remember receiving a call from which of the members of the fire department saying that this is a terrible problem and they're not going to be able to contain it. We also had been in touch with our people in the building who told us that all the personnel, all the people who worked in the building, all the personnel in that building had been evacuated. And at that point, it became obvious that building was on its way down. And by golly, it was the last of the buildings to come down on 9/11. Fortunately, it was the first of the buildings to come back after 9/11, and that's where it is today.
Thank you. The speaker in the rear.
Thank you, sir. Regarding that quote, sir, the fire department commander at the time of 9/11 was Chief Daniel Nigro, and he recently made a statement in which he denied having that conversation with you about Building 7. And plus, we know from FEMA reports that the firemen were pulled out of the building much earlier in the day due to lack of water supply. So, sir, could you please get it on the record exactly who was it from the fire department that you spoke to about Building 7 on that day? Thank you.
Go on to the next question.
What an answer.
What an answer.
Go on to the next question, please.
Okay.
3,000 people died, sir. Can we get an answer, please?
Answer.
Shame on you.
Answer.
You know, okay. Excuse me. Let me just take it. Thousands of people's lives were lost on 9/11. There are thousands of pages of testimony as to what transpired. Millions of hours were spent analyzing what caused those twin towers to come down and thereafter 7. All of that is public record. We don't have to spend any more time on that.
Then why doesn't the government have explanation? Then why doesn't the government... Wait. Then why doesn't the government have an explanation, sir? If you do, why don't they?
Okay. First responder heard the countdowns of Lowell Building 7 from 1 to 10.
Enough.
Okay.
The topic is the future of Lower Manhattan.
Sir, you're disturbing our educational mission here, which is...
This is education!
You don't want to answer the question, but first responders, they know what happened, and they're coming forward, so...
Thank you for making your points. Our next question, please.
Hi.
Is there in the back, sir?
Yes,
sir. No, in the back,
is there a person? The air in the room, sir? Can you guarantee the people in Lower Manhattan the air will be safe to breathe?
We have a question in the rear, sir. Please, we have not.
That's a fair question for you future investors.
I'm monitoring the questions, please.
Why did you give me that? That's a fair question.
Nicholas Grangey. I'm a student as well. My question, I don't mean to be antagonistic or any way divisive, but with respect to what the first gentleman asked, I would just hope that we could clarify that, because there is a good deal of controversy about the comments that you had previously made in 2001 on that PBS documentary.
This question has already been asked, and
I understand, but it's
the purpose of today's conference is to discuss the redevelopment of the World Trade Center site and the future of Lower Manhattan. It's not focusing on 9/11. So if anyone else would like to ask a question, the future of Lower Manhattan. It's not focusing on 9/11. So if anyone else would like to ask a question relating to that. It's the same question.
For right now. Hi, I'm Judy Jones and Mark Moore. Thank you for appearing and taking time out of your busy day to talk with us. This is kind of a female question. Do you see, or when do you see, better female shopping stores in our area?
We're going to get 500,000 square feet of shopping. Solid female shopping. Down at the Trade Center.
Hi, my name is David Chen. I have one question. With regard to insurance, World Trade Center says, I was wondering how you can attempt to justify the attacks, the fall of towers and the fall of Building 7 as two separate terrorist incidents as opposed to just one.
Well, there's a court system in America that provides for disputes of this nature, and after protracted litigation, the court settled that half of the companies that had signed on to any particular form of policy were only responsible for one event. The other half of the companies who had signed on to another form were responsible for two events. And as a result, appeals were taken, and the decisions were finally rendered by the appeals court, and it is a done issue at this juncture. I would say it would be easy to justify when you have two planes coming to two separate towers at two distinct time frames, bringing the two towers down independently. You can call that anything but two events. And so I was going to tell you what the case got resolved based upon the forms, the specific forms, and what those specific policies held in their language as being controlling one event or two events. And those companies that have been declared to have signed on to one form, to one event policy, were paid one event, and those who signed on to two, paid two. That was it. Yeah.
This will be our last question from student.
As soon as the event was over, you saw Larry run out, literally run out. I never saw an old person run so fast. Run out the back door.
I remember getting a call from the fire department commander telling me that they were not sure they were going to be able to contain the fire. I said, you know, we've had such terrible loss of life. Maybe the smartest thing to do is pull it. And they made that decision to pull, and then we watched the building collapse.
Last few seconds, he took his hand off, and you heard 3, 2, 1, and he was just saying, just run for your life, just run for your life. And then it was like another 2, 3 seconds, you heard explosions, like, ba-boom!
Jackie, yeah.